Hey guys, how's it going? Hope everybody's doing well out there today. In this video, we're going to take a look at a service called Dockge. Now, we've already taken a look at Dockge in the past, but some new features have come available for Dockge, and I want to talk about that in this video. This video kind of assumes that you're already familiar with Dockge. If you're not, that's fine. I've already made a couple of videos about Dockge, how to get it set up, and some different things that you can do with it. So definitely check those videos out. I'll have those linked in the video description down below. So what we're going to do in this video is take a look at setting up Dockge agents. And basically what those allow you to do is manage multiple Dockge instances from one dashboard. And I think you guys are going to really enjoy knowing that you can do this with Dockge. This is a very, very simple process. In my opinion, actually easier than setting up a portainer agent. So with all of that out of the way, let's go ahead and take a look at getting Dockge agents configured. Okay, so this is my Proxmox testing server. This is where I'd run everything or test everything out before I try to decide whether or not I'm going to put it into production. Here we can see that I've got four different instances of Dockge. That's just how I've got this set up again for this tutorial. It doesn't matter if you're on Proxmox or you're doing bare metal or whatever. As long as you're running a Docker server with Dockge, this should work without issue. So if we come up to the top of my browser, we can see all these different tabs. I've got Dockge, 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 Dockge. Basically, I've got 1, 2, 3, and 4 there. And this is what we're going to use for the sake of this tutorial. And again, this is super, super easy to get set up. So we're going to go to Dockge 1. Just for the sake of simplicity here, over here on the right-hand side, you should see Dockge agents. If you don't, make sure that you update to the most current version of Dockge so that you do see the Dockge agents option there. All you got to do is just click add agent and then put in the URL of one of your other Dockge nodes. Very, very simple stuff here. I've got my notes down here somewhere. So I'll go ahead and just paste in the URL. This is for Dockge number 2. This is this one right here. We can see this is 0.34 on port 5001. So that's what I'm putting in right there. Then I'm going to put in the username and the password for that Dockge instance, and then I'll click connect. Hey, just like that, agent added successfully. That's how easy it is to set up a Dockge agent. But let's do it two more times, just so we've got four nodes available to us for this testing and this demonstration purpose. So again, I'm going to click add agent. I'm going to put in the URL of Dockge 3, which is .16, which we can see right here in this URL bar right there. Again, I'll put in the username and password for that Dockge instance and click connect. Hey, look, agent added successfully. And we're showing all of these as being online, so everything is working the way we want it to. So let's do this one more time. I'm going to set up Dockge agent number 4 here. Oops. Let's just grab it from there. My notes are being stupid. All right, let's do this. We're just going to paste that in there again, username and password, just like before, and we'll click connect. Oops, I guess I can close that. And all of our agents are online. It says we've added that successfully, so we are good to go. That's how easy it is to actually add an agent from one Docker or one Dockge instance to another. So we've got four Dockge instances available to us from this dashboard, the one we're on and the three remote agents. So now let's take a look at getting some Docker containers up and running on these different nodes. So now let's go ahead and deploy a Docker container using Dockge, but let's put it on a different machine entirely, or a different container, I guess, in this particular instance, because of the way I've got my stuff set up, but I'm being pedantic here. So let's click compose up here in the top left. I'm going to go ahead over here in the little text editor over here. I'm going to put in the Docker compose for Hoogle. This is going to be on port 5000. I'm going to call this Hoogle right here. And what I want to do next is where it says Dockge agent, I can either put it on the current node or I can select any of these other nodes that I want. For the sake of demonstration, I'm going to put it on this .34, which is Dockge number 2. And then we'll just click deploy. So now it's going to go ahead and pull everything. While it's doing that, we can jump over here just to see if anything is going on right here. Hey, look, there's Hoogle. It is definitely doing some stuff in the background there. Let's come back over to here and I'll wait for this to deploy. Cool, network is creating, container is creating. We come over to here again, Hoogle is active now. Hey, look at that right there. So from here, and it says starting, that's good. Again, we're on our agent node. This is node number 2, right? So I can toggle back and forth between this. So this currently, or actually still says starting. So we're gonna give this another moment and then we'll go ahead and get it launched. Okay, so here we are just a couple of moments later, and this says now that it is healthy and it's running on port 5000. So let's jump over to node number 2. Here we can also see it says it's healthy, running on port 5000. So from either node number 2 or like we're trying to accomplish here from node number one's dashboard, I can just click 5,000 right there. And hey, look, we're on .34, which is is Dockage number two on port 5,000. And there is Hugel. Just that quickly and easily, we've managed to set up three agents on three different nodes and get a container deployed from node number one onto node number two. Let's do a couple of more demonstrations just for the sake of showing how this works, and then we'll go ahead and wrap things up here. So we're going to come back over here to node number one. We're going to add a new compose. We're going to delete this. We're going to paste this in. We're going to do hasty paste here. And we're going to come over here to the stack name, hasty paste, and let's go to node number three, which is .16. And of course, we've got that one right over here. So I'll go ahead and click on deploy. Again, it is pulling a Redis container and doing what it needs to do to deploy that. Hasty paste here says it is inactive, but of course it is still deploying. So I'm going to close Hugel there. Let's come over to Dockage number one. We'll see there's nothing going on here. But if I come over to Dockage number two, there is our hasty paste that is in the process of deploying. And then let's jump back over to one so that we can actually watch all of this kind of in real time as it deploys. So it's created our network, our volume, our Redis container, and now it is actually creating our paste bin clone hasty paste container right here. There we go. It says hasty paste is active. We can actually see the IP addresses under each of these. So if I jump back over to Dockage number two, right there is hasty paste. And again, I can just click that, and that's how quickly we are up and running. But for the sake of making sure that it's available from node number one, we're going to click the $79.99 right there. And hey, look, just as fast, just as easy, we were able to get that deployed on our node number two. So let's do one more just for the sake of it. I guess that was node number three. I probably said node number two multiple times. That was actually node number three because the first node was actually node number two. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Let's move on. For the sake of this last little bit of the tutorial here, let's do Wallace. We talked about Wallace in a previous video as well. So I'm going to close this hasty paste right here. So we've got 1, 2, 3, and 4, just so I can count in my head. Again, we're going to do compose. I'm going to do Wallace like so. I'm going to paste in our Docker compose. I'm going to go to node number 4, I guess, if I can keep my numbers straight this time. And I'm going to click deploy. So that actually happened really, really fast. And here we can see that Wallace is running on .15, which is our, again, node number 4. My numbers, I have a hard time with numbers. I'm going to go ahead and click just port 80 right there. Hey, look, there's Wallace. Now we can get Wallace set up. But for the sake of making sure, here is node number 4 on .15. Here's our Wallace container. And if I click on port 80 right there, there it is. Now we can get this set up from either of those two different dashboards. It'll take us to the exact same spot. Okay, so I know that there's going to be a question that will come up in the comment section down below, and that is, what if I go to, say, node number 2 or node number 3 or node number 4 and install a container from that node natively? Well, let's take a look at that real quick. So we're going to jump over here to node number 2. Right here, we've got we can see hasty paste is still up and running there. I'm going to click compose. I'm going to paste in, I've got a Vault Warden Docker compose down here, right? Just like so. I'm going to grab that and put that in for the stack name. And then under this, it says Dockage Agent. We've only got this available to this node. So we're just going to do the current setup here. We're going to click deploy. We're going to give this a second to do its thing. All right. So now Vault Warden is up and running on port 8181 there, just like that. But if we come over to node number one again, right there is our new Vault Warden on port 8181 on that .16, just like hasty paste was when we installed it from this node. So that's how easy it is to manage multiple nodes using Dockage agents. So that's it, guys. That's how easy it is to get Dockage agents set up and deploy Docker containers from one node to any of the other nodes that you've got agents attached to. I really dig that this has been added to Dockage. Now, I will say that this actually came out, I believe, in January. But I was unavailable. I was in the hospital most of January, so I'm a little bit late. That kind of is the shtick on this channel, is that I am fashionably or sometimes even unfashionably late to certain topics. Again, I think this came out in January and I'm just now getting to it. But hopefully you found this information helpful. If you did, it would mean a lot to me if you give the video a thumbs up, maybe consider getting subscribed to the channel. If you wanted to support in other ways, of course, I've got Patreon that you could go join. You could become a channel member. Or if you just want to hang out and chat with some people, I will have a link to my Discord down below as well. But I think that's everything that I wanted to cover in this video. So again, thank you so much for spending a few minutes of your day with me today, and I'll talk to you in the next video.